Hey everyone, I'm Anand and today we are diving into animator transitions and scripting. Now, before we dive in, let's quickly recap what we covered in our last session. We set up a simple state machine for our character, Buddy, allowing him to smoothly transition from an idle animation to a walk animation. If you missed that video, make sure to check it out before continuing with this one. Let's pick up where we left off. Right now, Buddy seamlessly transitions from idle to walk. But what if we want more control over these transitions? Here in the animator window, we can see our transitions represented visually. Each transition represents a change from one animation state to another. But there's more to it than just connecting arrows. Firstly, we can have multiple transitions between two states with different conditions. If that is the case, we can tweak the properties of a transition by selecting one from here. Take a look at the properties of a transition. We have options like has exit time and fixed duration. These control when and how transitions occur. For example, has exit time ensures that a transition only occurs once the current animation has finished playing. This is normalized time, means setting it to 1 would only let the transition happen once the entire animation gets played. Let me tell you, exit time is your best friend. Fixed duration allows us to specify a consistent transition time regardless of the animation length. Interruption source is a bit more advanced, but bear with me. It allows transitions to be interrupted by other animations under certain conditions. If our character is in the middle of an idle animation and we suddenly want them to jump, interruption sources lets us smoothly transition from idle to jump without any awkward pauses. It's a cool feature, but don't worry too much about it for now. As we get more comfortable with animations, we can explore interruption sources. But for now, let's focus on mastering the basics. Transition duration lets us control the blending of the two states. We can also add conditions here for this transition to occur. To set up conditions, we need some memory or variables known as parameters. We can go to the parameters panel, and currently it is empty. We can add variables by clicking on this plus icon, and we can add a float, int, bool, or a trigger. And we can assign a condition for the transition to occur based on these parameters. Okay, float, int, bool are similar to the coding equivalents. Trigger works similar to bool, but is useful to transition to one-shot animations like our jump animations. Now let's apply what we have learned. We want Buddy to transition back to idle from walk seamlessly. To do that, we'll create a new transition from walk to idle and adjust the properties to our liking. Let's create a parameter of type float and call it speed. And then we add a condition to this transition saying, hey, this transition should occur when the speed is less than, let's say, 0.1. And similarly, we can reverse this condition in the other transition and say go to walk when speed is greater than 0.1. If we hit play, select Buddy, and manually change this value, the transition occurs, and if I set it back to 0, it goes back to idle. We can also see that the transition occurs, but only after it is done idling. Well, this is because of exit time. If we uncheck that on both transitions, it happens instantly when the conditions get satisfied. Also, people love responsive characters. So what I like to do is to change the duration of this transition to 0.1 or less. This makes sure there is blending, but it is fast enough for the naked eye to make it seem responsive. Perfect. Now, Buddy smoothly transitions between idle and walk animations. But what about jumping and attacking? Let's set up transitions for these actions as well. But here's a pro tip. Instead of manually connecting transitions from every state to jump and attack, we can use what's called any state. This nifty feature allows transition to happen from any state, making our lives a whole lot easier. For this, we'll create triggers called jump and attack, and we'll jump when the jump parameter is triggered and attack when the attack parameter is triggered. Okay? Note, we should manually create transitions back to idle and walk from each of these, but what should be the condition here? Have a think about it. That's right, we can use the speed once again. we can go back to idle when speed is less than 0.1 and to walk when speed is greater than 0.1. Let's do the same thing for attack.
Awesome.
With our transition setup, Buddy is now a dynamic animated character. But we're not done yet. Let's talk about scripting. Wouldn't it be cool if we could somehow dynamically control these transitions through code? Well, guess what? We can. In this script, I have already defined functions for movement, jumping, and attacking. Now we just need to tie these functions to our animator controller. First, we need a reference to the animator component. And at start, we get the animator component using the getComponent function. First, let's do movement. And inside our move function, we can say anim.set, and we need to set float, and we pass in the name of the parameter, speed, and the value will be input vector.magnitude. Note, this is just a basic example, and we can pass in any float value to this function. Sometimes you may want to pass in the rigid body velocity or a current speed variable from your script. It all depends on the way you write your code. Okay? And now if we play, we can smoothly transition between idle and walk.
Nice.
Let's also do something similar for jump and attack. And because they are triggers, it's super easy to do. On our jump function, we say anim.setTrigger jump. And on the attack function, after we attack, same thing, anim.setTrigger attack. And just like that, we have a fully functional state machine driven by code. Before we wrap up, let's take a moment to reflect on what we have accomplished today. We have learned about animated transitions and dipped our toes into scripting. But remember, this is just the beginning of our journey into Unity animation. In our next video, we'll explore animation layers for even more control of our characters' movements. As always, if you have any questions or need clarification, feel free to leave a comment below.
And don't forget to subscribe.
Until next time, take care. See ya. Bye-bye.